In this video, we're going to talk about the recent updates to the IBCS Bullet Chart. To begin with, let's talk about the newly added template options. There are 7 different template options to choose from so that users don't have to waste time navigating the property sheet. There are 2 chart templates based on the newly added IBCS Bullet Chart, one with the comparison band and one without the comparison band. Each template has its own unique chart configuration. So let's drag in the actual and the target value, and the chart is ready. Multiple KPIs can be visualized in case of IBCS bullet chart. So along with the revenue, let's add the sales, and you can also enable the comparison band if you would like. 2 key differences both of these charts is that IBCS bullet chart focuses on highlighting the positive and negative variances with the help of the variance bar, and the second, it normalizes the target for better readability and understanding. Also, with the standard bullet chart, you can only visualize 1 KPI split across different categories, for example, sales by region. And in case of IBCS bullet chart, you can visualize multiple KPIs without a category field. The new bullet chart also provides the flexibility to include the variance bar for the standard bullet chart use case, where you can visualize a single KPI broken down by a category field. The other enhancements include the updates made to the advanced editor section, where target customization and comparison band section have been moved to the advanced editor. So let's customize the target marker and choose a circle. You can enable the comparison band and choose between a qualitative range and a comparative series. You can add up to 5 different qualitative ranges, and in case of comparative series, it acts as a third value to compare with the actual target. So let's turn this off and move on to the analytics section, where you can add both reference lines and reference band. So here I have a predefined reference line displaying the average value. So let's rename it to average, and you can choose between horizontal and vertical and different options like min, max, or even a fixed value by using the constant option. Moving on to the reference band section, you can add multiple reference bands similar to the reference line. The only difference is that you need to define both the start and the end value for the band. Lastly, the standard bullet chart has a few additional properties centered around the single KPI mode. A single KPI mode is one which has only values and no category field. So similar to the linear gauge, you can either display band names as labels or in legends, and highlight the active band in which the actual value lies using the active label band property. So let's rename the default labels to something more meaningful like bad, average, and good. These were some of the powerful new updates to the bullet chart visual by IBCS. Thank you for watching.